Hello, truth seekers, and welcome back to our channel, where we unveil the shocking truth behind the glamorous world of Prince Harry and Meghan Markle. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our channel. I'm your friendly neighborhood critic, and boy, oh boy, do I have a juicy story for you today. We're talking about none other than Prince Harry, the Duke of Sussex, and a roasting so brutal it could make a rotisserie chicken blush. So, Prince Harry, probably sitting in his Montecito mansion, scrolling through his phone, when bam, he sees Serena Williams, tennis legend and supposed friend, absolutely barbecuing him at the ESPY Awards. I mean, we're talking a roast so savage it makes Gordon Ramsay look like a kitten. But before we delve into the tumultuous waters of this revelation, if you haven't already, do me a favor and hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. You won't want to miss the explosive content we have in store. So now let's set the scene. Harry's just received the Pat Tillman Award for his work with the Invictus Games. Sounds great, right? A nice pat on the back for our ginger prince. But hold on to your crowns, folks, because this is where it gets messy. Apparently, some people think Harry only got this award because of his royal connections. It's like they're saying, hey, you got a participation trophy for being born into the right family. Ouch, talk about a royal burn. But wait, it gets even better. Serena Williams, who's supposed to be besties with Meghan, gets up on the stage and drops this bomb. Please, Harry and Meghan, try not to breathe too much tonight, because this is my night and I don't want to be overshadowed by accusations you guys are taking up too much oxygen. I mean, come on. That's not just throwing shade, that's launching a full-on eclipse. It's like she took all the drama surrounding Harry and Meghan, rolled it into a ball, and spiked it right back at them. Talk about a grand slam. Now I know what you're thinking, but they're friends, surely it was all in good fun. Well, let me tell you something, folks. In the world of celebrities, sometimes your friends are the ones holding the knife and twisting it. But let's rewind a bit and talk about this award. The Pat Tillman Award is supposed to be for people making remarkable civic contributions and showing extraordinary fortitude and spirit of service. Now, I'm not saying Harry hasn't done good work with the Invictus Games, but some people are side-eyeing this harder than a teenager caught sneaking in after curfew. And it's not just random people throwing the shade. Nope, Pat Tillman's own mother apparently had some choice words about Harry getting this award. It's like the royal drama has spread so far, it's now affecting the football moms in America. What a time to be alive. But here's where it gets really juicy. Apparently, some people think Harry's trying to hog the limelight while his brother and sister-in-law are dealing with Kate's cancer diagnosis. I mean, talk about bad timing. It's like showing up to a funeral in a party hat. Not a good look, Harry. And let's not forget about Meghan in all this. The poor woman can't even promote her products without being accused of trying to upstage Kate. It's like she's playing a game of royal whack-a-mole, except every time she pops her head up, someone's there with a sledgehammer. But you know what really gets me? The fact that Harry and Meghan just can't seem to catch a break. They're like the royal family's punching bags at this point. They sneeze and suddenly they're accused of trying to spread the common cold to overthrow the monarchy or something. I mean, think about it. They left the royal family to escape all this drama, and now they're getting more flanked than ever. It's like they jumped out of the frying pan and into a volcano. They can't even breathe without someone accusing them of stealing oxygen from babies or something. And let's talk about this whole distracting presence thing. Apparently, the royal family thinks Harry and Meghan are too distracting to have at events. Well, excuse me for thinking that a family gathering should include, oh, I don't know, the whole family. It's like they're treating Harry and Meghan like that one uncle who always gets drunk at Christmas and tells inappropriate jokes. Except in this case, the inappropriate joke is their entire existence. But here's the thing that really gets me. In the middle of all this drama, Harry and Meghan are still out there trying to do good. They're working on charitable causes. They're speaking out about mental health. They're trying to use their platform for something positive. But does anyone care about that? Nope, everyone's too busy analyzing their every breath like it's a secret code that'll reveal the location of the Holy Grail or something. And can we talk about the British media for a hot second? These folks are like bloodhounds when it comes to Harry and Meghan. They could cure cancer and end world hunger in the same day, and the headlines would probably be, Harry and Meghan selfishly put oncologists and aid workers out of jobs. It's ridiculous. But you know what, as much as we're all rolling our eyes at this drama, we can't look away. It's like a royal car crash, horrifying but oddly fascinating. We're all glued to our screens, waiting for the next bombshell to drop. And drop it will, mark my words, because if there's one thing we've learned from this whole saga, it's that the drama never ends. It's like a never-ending episode of Keeping Up with the Windsors, except with less contouring and more crumpets. So what's the moral of this story, folks? Well, for one, it's a reminder that fame and fortune don't guarantee an easy life. It's also a stark example of how quickly public opinion can turn. One minute you're the people's prince, the next you're the royal family's black sheep. Until then, stay tuned for more shocking stories and scandalous exposés on our YouTube channel. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to stay updated on the latest from the world of the royal family. Thanks for watching. We'll see you again with some more fascinating news about the royal family. Bye for now.